So hello guys and welcome back to my channel. Today again I am back with another circuit problem. Here in this circuit we have to calculate V1, V2 and also we have to calculate here V3 equals to what. And also we have to calculate current through 6 ohm resistor this. So we will solve the circuit problem using nodal analysis. So here suppose we have the current following this through this branch is I1 and through this is I2. And similarly here we have I3 and here we have I4 and assume here I5. So let's solve this using nodal analysis. So at node first, so here at this node we can directly write, here we have given 10 volt. So at this node we can directly write at node first V1 equals to, since we have 10 volt given already, so V1 equals to 10 volt. And at node 2, so at node 2, since at node 2 we know incoming current equal to outgoing current, and here we have I1 is the incoming current and I3 and I4 are the outgoing current. So here we can write I1 equals to I3 plus I4, and in place of I1 we can write here V1 minus V2 upon 2 using Ohm's law. So V1 minus V2 upon 2 and I3, so in place of I3 you can add V2 upon 8. So V2 upon 8, since here we have grounded here, so voltage at this point will be 0, and plus I4, so for I4 we have V2 minus 5 volt given here, so here we can write V2 minus 5 and minus V3 upon 1 ohm given here. So here if you solve this, here you will get 4V1 minus 13V2 plus 8V3 plus 40 equals to 0. And here we have 4V1 minus 13V2 plus 8V3 plus 40 equals to 0. And as we know V1 equals to 10 volt already we have obtained. So after substituting V1 equals to 10 volt here, since as V1 equals to 10 volt given, so after substituting V1 equals to 10 volt, we'll get here, we'll get the final expression as, here we'll get minus 13 V2 plus 8 V3 equals to minus 80, equation 2. And now at node 3, at node 3, so at this node, since we have I2 current and the same current is going here, since here we have I2 and we know incoming current equal to outgoing current, and here we have I4, so I4 is the incoming current and again I2 is also incoming current and I5 is the outgoing here. Here we have I5, so you can write here I2 plus I4 equals to I5. So here I2, since we have I2 this, so we can add V1 minus V3 upon 4, V1 minus V3 upon 4 plus I4. Since we have, for I4 you can add V2 minus 5 and minus V3 upon, we have given 1 ohm resistor, so 1 equals to I5. So for I5 we can add V3 upon 6, since we have grounded here. So V3 minus 0 upon 6 means V3 upon 6. V3 upon 6. So since again as we know V1 equals to 10 volt already we have obtained. So as V1 equals to 10 volt. So if you substitute V1 equals to 10 volt in this expression, we will get the expression in the form of V2 and V3. So after substituting, here we will get 12 V2 minus 2 V3 equals to 30, equation 3. So here after solving this, we will get the value of V2 and V3. So after solving, we will get here V2 equals to 1.143 volt and V3 equals to minus 8.143 volt. And also we have to calculate the current through 6 ohm resistor, means we have to calculate the I5. So for I5 we can calculate V3 upon, directly you can write here, for I5 equals to V3 upon 6. And we know V3 equal to minus 8.143. So minus 8.143 upon 6. So after solving we will get here minus 1.3571 ampere. And here negatives and it indicates that the current is in opposite directions. So in this way you can solve a circuit problems using nodal analysis. Thanks for watching the lecture.